This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. BBC Two is the second television channel operated by the British Broadcasting Corporation BBC in the United Kingdom, Isle of Man and Channel Islands. It covers a wide range of subject matter, but tending towards more highbrow programs than the more mainstream and popular BBC One like the BBC's other domestic TV and radio channels. It is funded by the television licence, and is therefore commercial-free. It is a comparatively well-funded public service network, regularly attaining a much higher audience share than most public service networks worldwide. Originally styled BBC Two, it was the third British television station to be launched, starting on 20 April 1964, and from 1 July 1967, Europe's first television channel to broadcast regularly in colour. It was envisaged as a home for less mainstream and more ambitious programming, and while this tendency has continued to date, most special interest programmes of a kind previously broadcast on BBC Two, for example the BBC Proms, now tend to appear on BBC Four instead. A high-definition version of the channel launched on 26 March 2013, replacing BBC HD Contents 1 History 11 Launch 12 Technological Advancements 2 Operation 3 Programming 4 Presentation 41 Regional Variations 5 Availability Outside the UK 6 Accessibility 7 BBC 2 HD 8 See also 9 References 10 External links History Launch British television at the time of BBC 2's launch consisted of 2 channels, the BBC Television Service and the ITV network, made up of smaller regional companies. Both channels had existed in a state of competition since ITV's launch in 1955, and both had aimed for a populist approach. In response, the 1962 Pilkington Report on the Future of Broadcasting noticed this, and that ITV lacked any serious programming. It therefore decided that Britain's third television station should be awarded to the BBC. Prior to its launch, the new BBC Two was promoted on the BBC Television Service, the soon-to-be renamed BBC One. The animated adverts featured the campaign mascots Hullabaloo, a mother kangaroo, and Custard, her joey. Prior to, and several years after, the channel's formal launch, the channel broadcast trade test transmissions, short films made externally by companies such as Shell and BP, which served to enable engineers to test reception, but became cult viewing. The channel was scheduled to begin at 19:20 on 20 April 1964 and show an evening of light entertainment, starting with the comedy show The Alberts, a performance from Soviet comedian Arkady Rykin, and a production of Cole Porter's Kiss Me, Kate, culminating with a fireworks display. However, at around 18:45, a huge power failure, originating from a fire at Battersea Power Station, caused Television Centre, and indeed much of West London, to lose all power. BBC One was able to continue broadcasting via its facilities at Alexandra Palace, but all attempts to show the scheduled programmes on the new channel failed. Associated Rediffusion, the London weekday ITV franchise holder, offered to transmit on the BBC's behalf, but their gesture was rejected. At 2200, programming was officially postponed until the following morning, as the BBC's news centre at Alexandra Palace was unaffected. They did in fact broadcast brief bulletins on BBC Two that evening, beginning with an announcement by the newsreader Gerald Priestland at around 19:25. There was believed to be no recording made of this bulletin, but a videotape was discovered in early 2003. By 11 o'clock on 21 April, power had been restored to the studios and programming began, thus making Play School the first program to be shown officially on the channel. The launch schedule, postponed from the night before, was then successfully shown that evening, albeit with minor changes in reference to the power cut. The transmission opened with a shot of a lit candle, which was then sarcastically blown out by presenter Dennis Toohey to establish the new channel's identity and draw viewers to it. The BBC decided that a widely promoted, lavish series would be essential in its earliest days. The production chosen was the Forsyte Saga 1967, a no-expense-spared adaptation of the novels by John Galsworthy, featuring well-established actors Kenneth Moore and Eric Porter. Critically, for the future of the fledgling channel, the BBC's gamble was hugely successful, with an average of 6 million viewers tuning in per episode, a feat made more prominent by the fact that only 9 million were able to receive the channel at the time. Technological advancements unlike BBC One and ITV, BBC Two was broadcast only on the 625-line UHF system, so was not available to viewers still using sets on the 405-line VHF system. This created a market for dual standard receivers which could switch between the two systems. The early technical problems, which included being unable to transmit U.S. recorded videotapes due to a lack of system conversion from the USNTSC system, were resolved by a committee headed by James Redmond. The new 625-line system had one noticeable advantage: the bandwidth was sufficient for color broadcasts, and indeed on 1 July 1967, during the Wimbledon Championships, BBC Two became the first channel in Europe to begin regular broadcasts in color. Using the PAL system, the 13-part series Civilization 1969 was created as a celebration of two millennia of Western art and culture to showpiece the new color technology. BBC One and ITV later joined BBC Two on 625-line UHF band, but continued to simulcast on 405-line VHF until 1985. BBC One and ITV simultaneously introduced PAL color on UHF on 15 November 1969, although they both had broadcast some programs in color and officially since at least late 1968. In 1979, the station adopted the first computer-generated channel identification ident in Britain, with its use of the double-striped orange 2 logo. The ident, created in-house by BBC engineers, lasted until March 1986 and heralded the start of computer-generated logos as the switch to digital-only terrestrial transmission progressed. BBC Two was in each region in turn the first analog TV channel to be replaced with the BBC multiplex, at first 4, then 2 weeks ahead of the other 4 channels. This was required for those relay transmitters that had no current Freeview service, giving viewers time to purchase the equipment, unless they had already selected a satellite or cable service. The last region for BBC Two to end on analog terrestrial television was Northern Ireland on 10 October 2012. It was announced on 19 February 2013 that a HD simulcast of BBC Two would commence on 26 March 2013 at 6 o'clock. This is the single UK service without national variations at the 2012 Guardian Edinburgh International Television Festival. BBC Two was named Terrestrial Channel of the Year. Operation the channel controllers had been, 1964-1965, Michael Peacock 1965-1969, David Attenborough 1969-1974, Robin Scott 1974-1978, Aubrey Singer 1978-1982, Brian Wenham 1982-1987, Graham MacDonald 1987-1992, Alan Yentob 1992-1996, Michael Jackson 1996-1999, Mark Thompson 1999-2004, Jane Root 2004-2008, Rolly Keating 2008-2014, Janice Hadlow 2014-2016, Kim Schillinglaw. Adam Barker served as acting controller of the channel, after Janice Hadlow left the channel in March 2014 and until Kim Schillinglaw began as new permanent occupant of the post since 2013. The controller of BBC Two has been given the expanded title controller of BBC Two and BBC Four, with ultimate oversight of the BBC Four service added to their duties. A BBC Four channel editor, reporting up to this controller, has day-to-day operation control of four. The channel forms part of the BBC Television Executive Group, and is answerable to the head of that department, and to the BBC Trust. On 20 January 2016, Kim Schillinglaw announced that she has decided to leave the BBC as the controller of BBC Two. BBC Two remit. BBC Two's remit historically was one screening programs targeting the arts, culture, some comedy and drama, and appealing to audiences not already served by BBC One or ITV. Over its first 30 or so years, the channel developed a reputation for screening highly praised and prestigious drama series, among these Boys from the Black Stuff 1982 or 1996's, critically acclaimed Our Friends in the North. The channel's highbrow profile is also in part attributable to a long history of demanding documentaries of all types, beginning with Civilization and the Ascent of Man in the 1960s, like the early Channel 4. BBC Two also established for itself a reputation as a champion of independent and international cinema. Under the Screen 2 brand, the channel has sometimes been judged, increasingly in more recent years, to have moved away from this original role and to have moved closer to the mainstream since the launch of the digital-only BBC Four. The BBC has been accused in particular of shifting its more highbrow output to the new channel, which, until the end of the UK's digital TV switchover in October 2012, a minority 75% in the final quarter of 2010 of viewers did not receive BBC FOS remit is very similar to that of the earlier remit of BBC Two, and contains many documentaries and arts programming. It has been perceived by some that this strategy is to allow BBC Two to show more popular programs and to secure higher ratings. Since 2004, there have been some signs of an attempt to return closer to parts of BBC Two's earlier output with the arts strand. The Culture Show, its most popular program at the moment, is Top Gear. Much of BBC Two's output has previously or subsequently been shown on other channels. Some of these programs are repeats of popular or flagship programs from BBC Four in a late night strand, originally called BBC Four on Two but now unbranded, for the benefit of audiences without access to BBC Four. Other programs are moved to the channel as a result of their success on BBC Three or Four, so that subsequent series are well received. An example of this is the BBC Three series Torchwood that was transferred to the channel following the success of the first series. BBC Two is also used as a testing ground for programs prior to their moving to the flagship BBC One. Such examples include Have I Got News for You and popular comedies Absolutely Fabulous and Miranda, which moved to BBC One after success on Two. Also in August 2014, The Great British Bake Off moved to BBC One due to its success the previous year on BBC Two. Another founding part of BBC Two was to provide educational and community programming on the BBC. As part of its public service remit, the educational section of this commitment saw BBC Two broadcast a large amount of programming for the Open University, who co-produced programming with the corporation, and saw the channel broadcast BBC Schools programs from 1983 until the programs were transferred to the BBC Learning Zone in 2010. As a result of the channel's commitment to community broadcasting, the channel produced the Symbolic Open Space series, a strand developed in the early 1970s in which members of the public would be allotted half an hour of television time, and given a level of editorial and technical training in order to produce for themselves a film on an issue most important to them. BBC Two's community program unit kept this aspect of the channel's tradition alive into the 1990s in the form of video diaries and later Video Nation. The community programs unit was disbanded in 2004. BBC Two originally showed children's programming in the morning, with two different blocks, CBBC and CBeebies First, at 6. News program was created at 11. Weekend mornings they show old black and white movies followed by a double bill of nature programming of David Attenborough, and occasionally an omnibus of programs that have been during the week including Great Railway Journeys. They also started showing Sine Zone in the early hours after 12:20. All of the identity packages used since the channel's launch in 1964 have featured a prominent numeral 2 in the design. Notable designs include the electronic double stripe 2, the white 2 ident, the only ident not to use a numeral 2, and most notably the 1991 2s. The 1991 2s featured a sans serif numeral 2 at the center of an initially art-related scene. However, the idents moved away from this style later on as the station's style changed. Although highly praised, this expansive set of idents was ended in November 2001. The BBC corporate logo was updated within the idents in October 1997, though the idents moved away from the original Viridian colour scheme in these latter years. The subsequent presentation style was introduced on the 19th of November 2001 and kept the same figure 2, but in a yellow background and given a personality at the time. BBC Two became the first BBC channel to feature a box logo in 2007. BBC Two debuted the new theme, A Window on the World, with the 2 numeral providing that view, introduced on the 18th of February 2007. The new look also saw the channel adopt a new teal-colored box logo, featuring the BBC logo above the name 2 in the font Avenir in 2014. Some of the 1990s idents were reintroduced, with a white box at the bottom right of the screen with the 2007 logo, which rotates to reveal the words 50 years to its left. There was also a special anniversary ident with the same 50 years logo variant in the corner on the 1st of January 2015, BBC Two permanently reintroduced and modified the selection of the 1990s. Idents used in 2014, implementing the teal box logo whilst ridding of the 50 years logo. However, BBC Two Northern Ireland have opted for a centralised text-only logo and, unlike the other regional variations of BBC Two, are currently airing nearly 40 idents from the 1991-2001 set regional variations. BBC Two also has regional variations in the nations, Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland. The nations' versions of BBC Two share the same idents, but with the nation name in the BBC Two box. BBC Two Scotland shows a lot of specifically Scottish programming on the channel, as well as its sister channel BBC One Scotland, and the schedules are often mixed around to match BBC Two Northern Ireland and BBC Two Wales. Both have the option to opt out, however they generally stick to the network schedule, only opting out a couple of times each week until December 2008. BBC Wales broadcast a special, digital-only channel, BBC Two W, which contained more opt-outs than analog-only BBC Two Wales. BBC Scotland occasionally broadcast Gaelic-language programmes under the banner BBC Two Alba in England. Many of the English regions were combined to form super-regions, such as the entire North or Midlands. These had the option to opt out of the network programming on the analog feed, and replace it with local programming. However, this was usually only done in exceptional circumstances, as all regular regional programming has been transferred to BBC One. And the English regions are not available on digital on BBC Two. There is no specific BBC Two England. This role is fulfilled by the network BBC Two. Availability outside the UK. BBC Two is widely available in the Republic of Ireland on cable and MMDS, as well as being received directly in areas bordering Northern Ireland, or in coastal areas from Wales. It is also available on cable and IPTV in the Netherlands, Belgium, Switzerland and Liechtenstein on 27 March 2013. It began being carried by British Forces Broadcasting Service BFBS to members of HM forces and their families around the world, replacing the BFBS 2 TV channel, which already carried a selection of BBC 2 programmes. It shares a channel with CBBC, which broadcasts from early morning until the early evening. Accessibility. The BBC announced in May 2008 that it had achieved its aim for all programming to have subtitles for viewers with hearing difficulties. These are available on the BBC Red button, and until 23 October 2012, via the CFAX teletext service. The BBC also offers audio description on some popular programmes for visually impaired viewers, as well as sign language interpretation on some of its programmes for deaf and hard of hearing viewers. The percentage of the BBC's total television output with audio description available is 10%, having been increased from 8% in 2008. BBC Two HD. BBC Two HD logo. Originally, programs from BBC Two were shown in high definition on the dedicated BBC HD channel, alongside programs from BBC Three and BBC Four, as well as some select series from CBBC and CBeebies. However, in plans outlined by the Director General Mark Thompson on 6 October 2011, BBC HD would close to be replaced by BBC Two HD, a high definition simulcast of BBC Two that would work much the same way as BBC One HD. This move allowed the corporation to save £21 million, used to count towards its budget deficit following the freezing of the licence fee and the additional financial responsibility of addition services on 19 February 2013. It was announced that BBC Two HD would replace BBC HD from 605. See also BBC Portal Book, BBC Channels UK. History of BBC Television. Idents. List of television stations in the United Kingdom. References. Carrot. BBC Two HD channel goes live, replacing BBC HD. What Hi-Fi. 26 March 2013. Retrieved 9 July 2013. Carrot. ABCD, BBC, Media Centre, BBC Two HD channel to launch 26 March, BBC Online 19 February 2013. April 2013. Carrot. BFBS TV set for a makeover on 27 March, BFBS. Carrot. BBC Vision celebrates 100% subtitling. BBC Press Office, 7 May 2008. Carrot. About the BBC, policy on subtitles. BBC. Carrot. Freeview audio description. TV schedule. TV Help. External links. BBC Two at BBC Online. BBC Two, Happy 40th Birthday at BBC Online VE. BBC Television. BBC UK Channels. BBC One. CBBC CBeebies Joint Ventures and International Channels BBC Alba BBC America BBC Arabic Television BBC Brit BBC Canada BBC Earth BBC Entertainment BBC First BBC World News Community Channel UK TV North East and Cumbria North West Yorkshire Yorkshire and Lincolnshire West West Midlands East London South West South South East Defunct Channels BBC Choice BBC Prime BBC Select BBC 3 Broadsheet Financial Times The Daily Telegraph The Sunday Telegraph The Sunday Times Compact I The Times Middle Market Daily Express Daily Mail The Mail on Sunday Tabloid Daily Mirror Sunday Mirror Morning Star The Sunday People Daily Star Daily Star Sunday The Sun Sunday Sport Magazines and Other Periodicals List of Magazines by Circulation Radio 1 Extra Radio 4 Extra Radio 5 Live Sports Extra Radio 6 Music Asian Network BBC National DAB Multiplex Commercial Analog Digital Absolute Radio Classic FM TalkSport Digital Absolute 80s Absolute Radio 90s Absolute Radio Extra Amazing Radio BFBS Radio Digital 1 Multiplex Jazz FM Planet Rock Premier Christian Radio Sound Digital Multiplex Smooth Radio UK UCB UK Regional and Local Stations BBC List of BBC Local Radio Stations List of BBC Regional Radio Stations Commercial List of Community Radio Stations List of Local Commercial Radio Stations List of Semi-National Analog and Digital Stations Other Stations List of Hospital Radio Stations Pirate Radio Restricted Service License List of RSL Stations List of Satellite Radio Stations List of Student and Schools Radio Other Broadcasting House FM Broadcasting The Studios MediaCityic Radio Academy Radio Academy Awards Radio Independence Group Roger Most Listened to Programs BBC BBC 1 BBC 2 BBC 4 BBC News BBC Parliament CBBC CBeebies Channel 4 Channel 4 E4 Film 4 More 4 4 7 Channel 5 Channel 5 5 Star 5 USA Spike ITV ITV, STV, UTV ITV 2 ITV 3 ITV 4 CITV ITV Encore ITV BE Sky Challenge Pick Real Live Sky 1 Sky 2 Sky Arts Sky Atlantic Sky Cinema Sky Cinema Box Office Sky Living Sky News Sky Sports Sky Sports F1 Sky Sports News HQ UK TV Alibi Dave Drama Eden Gold Good Food Home Really W Yesterday Services and Platforms All 4 Film 4 Odd Analog Analog Terrestrial Defunct BBC iPlayer BBC 3 Online Blinkbox BT TV Cable Digital Digital Terrestrial List of Channels Freesat Freesat Freeview Freewire High Definition List of Channels ITV ITV Hub, STV Player Local Television My 5 Real Digital Restricted Service License Satellite List of Channels Sky Freesat from Sky On Demand Sky Sky HD TalkTalk TV Top Up TV TV Catch Up Virgin Media Filmflex TiVo VUView Zatu Studios BBC Elstree Centre BBC Pacific Key BBC Television Centre Broadcasting House Cardiff Fountain Studios The Leeds Studios The London Studios MediaCityic Gas Street Studios Granada Studios Austerly Television Centre Roth Lock Teddington Studios Television Centre, Southampton Other Defunct Channels Edinburgh International Television Festival History List of Years List of Channels Student Television Viewing Statistics Most Watched Broadcasts Essential Bauer Radio BBC Bloomsbury Publishing BT Group Channel 4 Daily Mail and General Trust Dentsu Aegis Network Economist Group Emmy Music Publishing Endemol UK Global Group Guardian Media Group Haymarket Informa ITN ITV Johnston Press Mecom Group News UK NewsQuest Northern. Other resources List of largest UK book publishers Government and regulatory bodies Advertising Standards Authority BBC Trust British Board of Film Classification British Film Institute Culture, Media and Sport Select Committee Department for Culture, Media and Sport Ofcom Press Complaints Commission S4C Authority UK Film Council Industry and Trades Bodies British Academy of Film and Television Arts British Phonographic Industry